Well, hello there, and welcome back to the channel. By popular demand, today we are finally going to take a look at my more or less kind of recently acquired BC Rich Gunslinger Retro. I'm going to give you kind of an overview on the specs on this thing, at least what I can provide. I mean, this thing obviously has been modified quite a bit before I got it, and I'll just give you some candid thoughts and opinions on this guitar. Oh, and if you're new here and you like the content on this channel, please make sure you hit like and subscribe. Thanks a bunch. If you're looking more for things like tones, that kind of stuff, I'm not gonna do a lot just because obviously that is not the stock pickup, so it wouldn't really be a good indicator of how this thing sounds if you do find one of these stocks. I will do some playing though, and I'll leave that at the back if that's what you're interested in. So just make sure you follow the timestamps along here and find yourself towards the back of the video, okay? Okay, so what is this thing? Obviously this is a BC Rich Gunslinger Retro. These were reissued kind of around 2010-ish. I'm not sure when production on them ended. They were made overseas, but the quality on them seems to be not too bad. This is the first one I've played. I bought it used, obviously, and it has already been modified quite a bit, as you can tell. But neat guitars. I mean, to me, they're synonymous with guitar players out of the 80s, like CeCe DeVille, who, of course, famously had one of these with a beautiful Nagle graphic on it. Anyway, one of those guitars I always wanted. These reissues, if I'm not mistaken, came in three colors. I think it was black, yellow, and of course this highlighter green, which is stupendous. And again, I don't really know when production on these stopped. I definitely saw new ones for sale as late as 2013, 2014, but no idea when production officially ended on these for this reissue. If anyone knows, leave me a comment below. Love to know. Alright, so the specs. As far as the body goes, we've obviously got a Super Strat on our hands here with some kind of pointy horns. This is nice, actually. It's got a really nice deep cut in here on the back for you to get your hand in there. This has also been recessed. I don't know if you can see that cut out there, so that's very comfortable when you're getting up here into the higher frets. Really nice access. One humbucker, one volume. This was added after by a previous owner, but this was all you got. It was just a volume knob and a humbucker and a Floyd Rose. That is it. That's the body. Basswood or basswood. Humbucker, Floyd. Nothing else, nothing fancy. This is really just kind of a bare bones stripped down shred machine. As far as beveling goes, obviously you've got, you know, the cutaway up here, and you've got a nice kind of recess here for your hand as well. Not that you're actually gonna get in there, but it is there. And you can see you've got a tummy cut there, but as far as like beveling on the front here, you've got a bit of an arm cut out here. Nothing too crazy again. Really just a very straightforward rock machine. This obviously does now have a coil split, which is fun, but not how these came stock. As far as the neck goes, we are looking at your regular style Fender scale length, 25.5 inches in scale length. We're looking at 22 frets, so you can get all the way up there and do your fiddly bits. This obviously is maple. The specs I did find on this say hard rock maple. Now, I think that's probably just a play on the word hard rock, but yeah, obviously it's maple. You can see that it is multiple pieces as well, but I gotta say, it feels very nice. Really, really comfortable profile. Kind of similar to that Kramer, the purple one back there that I've got, the Modern Striker. Very similar feeling profile to my hand anyway. We've got jumbo frets, which are quite nice. They're just regular frets. They're not stainless steel or anything like that. The radius itself is super flat, as you obviously can see. This is, I think, 16-inch radius, so really a shreddy guitar, but I mean, that's kind of obvious. What else would you be playing on this? Probably not jazz. Obviously, we've got dot inlays, nothing weird there. Pretty straightforward, standard rock stuff. All right, the headstock. So this, of course, is a reverse headstock, which looks ultra bitchin' and super 80s. This one's got Grover tuners on the back here, which are a little battle-worn, but I kind of like it. This is something the previous owner did. They look great. The ratios are good. If I'm not mistaken, the ones that came stock on these were just regular BC Rich tuners, nothing special. Again, it kind of doesn't matter much when you've got a lock nut anyway, because these aren't going to be doing much here tuning. But yeah, no complaints there. Just pretty standard fair stuff. All right, so the bridge on this. Obviously, this is a Floyd Rose with a silly stick. When these were first reissued, I'm not sure if this is true or not, but from all of the materials I'm finding, these came with an original Floyd Rose, or maybe it was a Floyd Rose 1000 in this position. Later on, I can see on all sorts of websites that they were sold with Floyd Rose specials, which this happens to be. So if you get one of these used, maybe it comes with a real Floyd. I mean, according to the marketing, that's what could be in there, but this one has a Floyd Rose special, which to me makes quite a bit of sense considering what the price point was on these guitars. Anyway, of course, this is, you know, a double locking tremolo, so we've got a lock up here, and it locks back here. And you know, this thing is, of course, super stable if you want to get stupid with the bar. I haven't really had any issues with it, honestly. I'm not going to change that. Floyd Rose special, I've had good luck with them. This one stays in tune like a champ. So yeah, good bridge. All right, there are some really weird things going on with this particular guitar that I figure I should mention anyway. When I first bought this, obviously I bought it used, looked pretty amazing, brought it home, started playing it, great. Some things seemed a little bit weird about it though. Not about the playability itself, just things kind of in weird spots that made me kind of scratch my head and wonder what the heck was going on with it. First thing I'm gonna mention, and some of you may have already noticed this, is right up here on the headstock, you can see that the truss rod cover doesn't say Gunslinger on it. All the pictures I've seen of other Gunslingers like this, they all say Gunslinger on the truss rod cover. Maybe somebody changed that, I don't know. The other thing that's kind of weird is we have a big kind of string tree thing here. I've never seen a string tree thing on one of these. They seem like, from the factory, they didn't come with one. I mean, somebody could have added this after. This guitar definitely has been modified, so perhaps that's something that happened. I'm not too sure, but kind of weird. Little unusual, doesn't affect anything, but not the right truss rod cover, not the right string tree. Strange. Now, another really weird thing about this particular model, obviously it's got the bridge split. They didn't come like this, but I swear I've seen one like this on AliExpress with one of those there. I'm not sure if this is maybe a counterfeit version of a Gunslinger Retro with a couple strange things off. It seems like it's a bit too well done to be from AliExpress. Honestly, I've got a few guitars from them, and the quality on this compared to those is quite staggering. This one is pretty well put together, but there's a few fishy things about it. That's one of them. So here's another really bizarre thing that threw me for a loop when I bought this. I didn't notice this until much later when I was playing it, but if you flip it on the back here, you can see the BC Rich logo stamp there, which looks right. And then down here on the heel plate, you can see the BC Rich heel plate, which is correct. Notice anything missing? There's no serial number on the base plate, which at first I thought was weird. I've been able to find a bunch of pictures of these guitars, and they all have serial numbers up here on the headstock, but there's no serial number up here on the headstock either. Now, I spent a good amount of time staring at this thing because this seemed really bizarre to me, and I'm not as freaked out about it as I was. It's probably not going to show up in the lighting here, but if you look right beside the BC Rich kind of logo thing on the back here, you notice the light might show a bit of scuffing. It looks like somebody has gone ahead and just scraped or wiped away the serial number as well as the country of origin. Yeah, kind of a weird thing. Anyway, not too sure why somebody would rub that off. Maybe they just didn't like the look of it. I'm just hoping this isn't stolen or fake or something like that. But yeah, bit of a strange oddity on this guitar. So aside from all the weird stuff with this guitar, I honestly quite like this. The neck is extremely comfortable. I like the way this plays. I mean, there's dings and dents. I don't get them to show up all over this guitar just because I figure it was probably made around 2010-ish. And it's definitely seen lots of play. I mean, there are blemishes too. I mean, this could have been a B-stock guitar for all I know, and then was just sold as a B-stock. Like, if you look on the fretboard right there, that looks like a knot or something that was in, you know, the fingerboard. A little bit of a strange thing to have there. I've never seen one on a board like that before. And also, I mean, I'm being really picky here, but if you look at the finish, there is one odd little flake in here, which is disruptive, and you can see it in the clear coat. Again, not serious stuff, just bizarre little things. It just aren't quite right about this guitar. Aside from these small little things, I honestly really like this guitar. I mean, I've done a couple modifications on this thing myself. Obviously, the humbucker here is now a Wilkinson hot overwound humbucker, which sounds pretty decent. It's been coil split for more tonal variety. I think I added this brass block here on the trem. Those don't come stock on Floyd Rose Specials, but you can honestly buy them from like Music Lily for I think a whopping $15 on Amazon, and it's brass. So yeah, cheap little upgrade. I prefer that. Overall, this is a great playing guitar. I really like it. If you can find one of these on the cheap, definitely jump on it. They're super, super fun. And I mean, just look at this finish. Look at this thing. This is a riot. Anyway, that's all I've really got to tell you guys about this particular guitar. I really like this reissue that they did. I'm kind of hoping we see one of these in the near future again with some more color options. That'd be fantastic. Yeah, great guitar. Highly recommend it. If you can find one of these used, definitely pick it up and give it a whirl. Anyway, let me play you guys out so you can kind of get a sense how this guitar plays and more or less sounds with these upgrades. Let's go! Good life is such a crime.